Students, we will see today what is trigonometry. Okay, from the name itself, it is we will divide it into two parts. Trigono means triangle, metri means measure. That means we are trying to measure the sides and angles of the triangle. So that is what you call, we are going to study in trigonometry. So trigonometry means the measurement of triangle. Measurement of triangle means, see here, measurement of triangle. Measurement of triangle means naturally what will be there, what is there inside the triangle? Angle, and then outside sides. So we are going to measure the angles and sides of the triangle. Okay, now that means triangle is trigonometry. Is the study of triangle. More especially, trigonometry is the study of right angle triangle. Especially trigonometry is the study of right angle triangle. Now, what do you mean by right angle triangle? Right angle triangle means it is a triangle whose one angle is 90 degree. Whose one angle is 90 degree. One of the angle is 90 degree. Okay, fine. Now, you tell me, now we will draw one right angle triangle. A, B, C. As I told you, one of the angle is 90 degree. From here, you can understand very well, this is 90 degree. So, we will put a box type. So, it will indicate it is a 90 degree or it is a right angle. Okay. Now, here one more we will see. This is theta. What is that called? Theta. Okay. Now, can all the three sides of the right angle triangle are equal? No, it cannot be, because always this side is longer than these two sides. So, three sides cannot be equal in a right angle triangle, whereas two sides can be equal. If at all, these two sides can be equal, but three sides cannot be equal. Okay, that is the reason why. Now, here, very carefully you have to see. Now, what is this side? Opposite to 90 degree. So, it is called hypotenuse. This is called a hypotenuse. So, what is hypotenuse? Side opposite to right angle is called hypotenuse. Fine. Now look at this angle theta. See, what is the side opposite to this angle theta? AB. Okay. Now, side opposite to angle theta is called opposite side. Okay, this is opposite side. Then see, for any triangle you have got three sides. This we have defined as hypotenuse, or we have named as hypotenuse. This we named it as opposite side. Then one more side is there. See, look at this. This side is adjacent to this angle theta. See, adjacent to this angle theta, there are two sides. One is hypotenuse, the another is side BC. But this side already we have named as hypotenuse. So which is the adjacent side? Yes, this. Therefore, side next to theta, next to angle theta, but not hypotenuse, but not hypotenuse, is called adjacent side. Okay. Now, we have seen what is the right angle triangle, how we are naming those three sides of the right angle triangle. Now, see, there are three basic functions in right angle triangle. There are three basic functions in trigonometry. That means, what are they? Each are one side of triangle divided by the other side. Now I will explain this. Now look at this. See, ABC is a right angle triangle, B is an angle 90 degree, this is theta. Now we are defining one basic function, that is sine theta equal to, theta is here, opposite side upon hypotenuse, opposite side upon hypotenuse. This is one trigonometrical ratio. The another one, A, B, C, this theta, we say cos theta equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. See, this is adjacent side. You can say here BC upon AC. Here you can say AB upon AC. Now, third possibility is that ABC 90 degree theta, tan theta equal to opposite side upon adjacent side. So these are the three basic trigonometrical ratios, or we call it as functions. Ratios also we see. Ratios. Now look at this. What is the short form? Sine theta is equal to S O H. Cos theta C A H. Tan theta, TOA. This is the shortcut formula to remember what is sin theta, what is cos theta, what is tan theta. Now inverse theta is there. Inverse means what? What is the inverse of sin theta? 1 upon sin theta. See, now another one. What is inverse ratio? See, inverse trigonometrical ratio. One upon sin theta. So we call it as cosec theta. So what is the formula? Inverse means, see, opposite side upon hypotenuse. Now ulta. hypotenuse upon opposite side. Similarly, what is the inverse of cos theta? It is called sec theta. So it is hypotenuse inverse upon adjacent side. Now what is the inverse of tan theta? That is called cosec theta is equal to adjacent side upon opposite side. So followed. So in trigonometry we have seen the definition of trigonometry and where we are going to use. It is used in engineering, astronomy, science, navigation and survey, etc. Okay, this much is about trigonometry. Okay.